Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it. Must be to the Lord, for He is worthy of our praise. No man on earth should give glory to himself. All the glory must be to the Lord. Oh, the glory must be to our God, for He is worthy of our praise. No man on earth should give glory to himself. Oh, the glory must be to our King. Thanks, thanks, we give you thanks, for you have done in our lives. We are so blessed, our soul has found rest. Oh Lord, we give you thanks. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. Jesus, precious Jesus, I love your name, I love your name. Jesus, precious Jesus, there is no other name I know. If you love his name, begin to worship him, begin to magnify him. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I want to appreciate you. I want to adore you. I want to magnify you for your faithfulness and for your mercy, for your loving kindness and for your compassion. Please accept my thanks and praises in Jesus' name. Thank you for loving me eternally. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your hand upon my life. Thank you for your glory over my life. Glory be to your holy name. Please accept my thanks and praises in Jesus' name. Thank you for feeding me with the word of life. Thank you for not allowing me to suffer the famine of your word. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. Thank you for health in my bones this day. Be thou glorified. Be thou honored. Be thou adored, my Father. Thank you for your love in my heart. Thank you for holding me with your right hand of righteousness. Be thou honored in the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name, we have given thanks. We want to take one or two prayer points quickly. You want to say, Father, illuminate my spirit and give me ideas that will translate to money. Brethren, we need money for the work of the kingdom. Therefore, we need to pray, Father, illuminate my spirit and give me ideas that will translate to money. Prayer in the name of Jesus. Leganica Santa Taribla Bajaja Garondo Blodo Locococho, Lundurilla Baba Bracocorilla Keshida, only by by your divine hand, that I can receive ideas. Therefore, my Father, I pray today you illuminate my spirit, man, by giving me ideas that will translate into money in the name of Jesus. I need the money to do the work of the kingdom. Money is needed to preach the gospel. Oh God of heavens and earth, give me ideas today. Illuminate my spirit, man. Give me ideas that will translate into money in the name of Jesus. So that money will no longer limit me in accomplishing for my master. You want to say, Father, cause me to be a blessing to my generation. I want to be an asset and not a liability in this generation, my Father. Hey, kanga tukurumo to kondalia, cause me to be a blessing. Cause me to be a blessing. Cause me to be a blessing. Cause me to be a blessing in my generation, in my place of work. Cause me to be a blessing in the household. Let me be a blessing in the neighborhood. Let me be a blessing in the church of God. Let me be a blessing in the body of Christ. Let me be a blessing in the community. Let me be a blessing in my nation. Let me be a blessing to the world at large. Let me be a blessing. Father, make me a blessing to my generation. Almighty God, make me a blessing to my generation. Liba soko toranda. Like keke rila bacha chadi degeke to sutaraga lide yekelende. Remama yegele de bekrobo kuchugriya baba. Make me a blessing. Make me a blessing. Make me a blessing. Make me a blessing. In the name of Jesus, you want to say, oh Lord, bless every mountain hindering my path to destiny. Ye kongo nina we ye gegeme ono yo gageble le yakatata. Odo bro mo gageble me yakasuko totorine ye keteteria. My Father, my God, bless every mountain hindering me from reaching my goal. Bless every mountain hindering my path to place of destiny. You have a good destiny for me. E ye ke toto ni ana majanga lili le kecheche. Rengimbro moko chochori anda lila la baba. Makokoro lolo moko chochori ni henge lili le kechira. Every mountain standing between me and my destiny. Every mountain blocking my path to destiny. Blast them today. 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 Thank you, everlasting Redeemer. And so my Father and my God, every prayer point we have raised before you, turn to testimonies in the name of Jesus. Turn them to testimonies in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. Blessed be your holy name. Even as we go into your word, speak to us. Send your word with power, that the sick among us will be healed instantaneously, that the oppressed will be delivered, that the captives among us will be set free, that yokes will be destroyed in the lives of your people. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that every sinner under the influence of my voice will become saints of God. In the name of Jesus, that all backsliders will be fully restored back to you. In the name of Jesus, that every saint will be re-energized and empowered to run this race to the end. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Redeemer. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today is Wednesday, April 4. Wednesday, 4th of April. The topic says, time to show your face. Enough of hiding. Time to do what? To show your face. And as the God of heaven lives, wherever you show your face, the glory of God will announce your arrival. In the name of Jesus, you are born to be a blessing, and you will be a blessing to your generation in every facet of life. In the name of Jesus, time to show your face. A memory verse is taken from Isaiah 60 verse 1. Arise, shine, for the light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. Arise, shine, for the light is come. Arise, shine, for the light is come. The glory of the Lord is risen, risen. The glory of the Lord is come. Come, the glory of the Lord is come upon us. This glory will never turn to shame in the name of Jesus. This glory will never be withdrawn in the name of Jesus. Our text is taken from 1 Kings 19, 1 to 19. 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 1 to 19. And Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done, and withal how he had slain all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a messenger unto Elijah, saying, so let the gods do to me, and more also, if I make not thy life as the life of one of them by tomorrow about this time. And when he saw that he arose and went, for his life, and came to Beersheba, which belonged to Judah, and left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness, and came and sat down under a juniper tree, and he requested for himself that he might die, and said, it is enough now, O Lord. Take away my life, for I am not better than my fathers. Verse 5. And as he lay and slept under a juniper tree, behold, then an angel touched him and said unto him, arise and eat. And he looked, and behold, there was a cake baking on the coals, and a cruse of water at his head. And he did eat and drink, and laid him down again. And the angel of the Lord came again the second time, and touched him, and said, arise and eat, because the journey is too great for thee. And he arose, and did eat and drink, and went in the strength of that meat 40 days and 40 nights unto Horeb, the mountain of God. Verse 9. And he came thither unto a cave, and lodged there. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him, and he said unto him, what doest thou here, Elijah? And he said, I have been very jealous for the Lord God of hosts, for the children of Israel are forsaking thy covenant, thrown down thy altars, and slain thy prophets with the sword. And I, even I only, am left, and they seek my life to take it away. And he said, go forth, and stand upon the mount before the Lord. And behold, the Lord passed by, and a great and strong wind rent the mountains, and break in pieces the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind, and after the wind an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. Verse 12. And after the earthquake a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire, and after the fire a still small voice. And it was so, when Elijah heard it, that he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood in the entering of the cave. And behold, there came a voice unto him and said, what doest thou here, Elijah? And he said, I have been very jealous for the Lord God of hosts, because the children of Israel are forsaking thy covenant, thrown down thy altars, and slain thy prophet with the sword. And I, even I only, am left, and they seek my life to take it away. 15th verse. And the Lord said unto him, go, return on thy way to the wilderness of Damascus. And when thou comest, anoint Hazael to be king over Syria, and Jehu the son of Nimshi shall thou anoint to be king over Israel, and Elisha the son of Shaphat of Abel-Meholah shall thou anoint to be a prophet in thy room. And it shall come to pass that him that escapeth the sword of Hazael shall Jehu slay, and him that escapeth the sword of Jehu shall Elisha slay. Yet I have left me 7,000 in Israel, all the knees which have not bowed unto Baal, and every mouth which hath not kissed him. 19, the last verse. So he departed thence, and found Elisha the son of Shaphat, who was plowing with 12 yokes of oxen before him, and he with the 12th, and Elisha passed by him, and cast his mantle upon him. From where we are read, quickly we can pick one or two points. Point one, based on verse 4 and 5, our feelings. He knows what you are passing through. That's why Jesus came in the flesh. He can feel for us. So when Elijah was tired and worn and said, no, I just want to die, kill me. Actually, I'm not better than my father. God said, okay. I know what you are passing through. I need to calm you down. And what happened? God offered him food. Jesus is a life giver. No wonder the Bible says in John 10:10, when he gives life, he gives it in abundance. Also, in verse 12, we can learn something else. We should learn to be still before God. You want to be hearing the voice of God. You need those calm moments before him. When you and I are busy jumping up and down, they are not likely to hear his voice. Particularly to hear it clearly and to receive divine information and instructions. So you want to be hearing the voice of God. Learn to be still before him. And also we can see in verse 19 that God always uses the diligent. Some of us in this era, it is when we are failing our workplace that we now say we have had the call of God. It is when we are sacked, we now want to go into the ministry. No, it shouldn't be so. You should be able to give up the work while you are still intact in that place of work. God met Elisha working. The Bible says in verse 19, so he departed then and found Elisha, the son of Shaphat, who was plowing. He was busy working. God will use the diligent, not the lazy. And that's why when you find people who have failed in life, who now find their way into the ministry, they will see end of failing in the ministry. Because the lazy cannot get anywhere. Our God is very, very diligent and committed to whatever he's doing. Out of 7 days, the Bible recorded our God worked for 6 days. He rested only the seventh day. Jesus said, hitherto my father walked and I walked. So I don't know who you want to resemble with your laziness. You want God to use you? Be diligent. In the place of prayer, be diligent. In studying the word of God, be diligent. In evangelizing, be diligent. Very soon, you will see God manifesting his hand through you. Now, let's go to the open heavens. Hiding our identity or deliberately putting ourselves in obscurity does not serve our interest or that of our Father in heaven. You get to a place of work, you don't want them to know you are a child of God. You get to a new environment, you don't want them to know that you stand for Christ. It ought not to be so. Some people misrepresent humility by thinking that being extremely introverted is a Christian virtue. Going by the command in today's memory verse, this is not so. Someone said the reason why the conjunction and is not found between the words arise and shine in Isaiah 61 is because the rising and the shining form a simultaneous equation. The two goes together as a command. Arise, shine. The moment your rising is in progress, you have to shine at the same time. The rising presupposes a prompting to shine at the same time. In other words, there is no time lag between your rising and your shining. God has just promoted you as a bank manager. Immediately you are resuming, carry the light of God. Let everybody in that office know that Jesus is Lord. God has given you an advantage now where you can have a breakfast meeting with your people, where you can have tea break and share the word of God. Arise, shine. As you are rising, begin to shine for the master. A failure to shine while rising has certain implications. Opportunity might be lost and lost forever. You will not be in that position forever. You are transferred to a new place. Immediately begin to shine. Because you don't know how long you will be there. Shine. Let the light of Christ be seen in you. Let it be known that a child of God passed through the place. When you rise, the Lord knows that your light has come and that he has bestowed his glory upon you. It then follows that if you refuse to shine while the glory of the Lord is arising upon you, and your time passes away, you will have failed God and miss a great opportunity. May you never fail God in life in Jesus' name. He's giving you an opportunity, please use it. He's just giving you a new house. You have relocated to another place. Let your light shine in that community. Let them know a child of God is around the corner. Arise and shine. Use every opportunity to shine for the Master. So don't try to miss the opportunity God is bringing your way. John 9, 4 and 5 said, I must work the works of him that sent me. While it is day, the night cometh, when no man can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. We age every day. When your light is rising and you are supposed to shine, you don't shine. Before you know it, your strength will diminish as age take a toll on you. Life take a toll on you and you are not strengthened to do all you should have done. While you are still young, please run for the Master. Do your best for him. This statement should bring to your remembrance that a time will come when Christians will no longer be in the world. Therefore, it is time for us to show our faces. We children of God have been in hiding for too long a time. We must now show ourselves in the areas of education, commerce, politics, the military, transport, agriculture, science, and technology, and in all other sectors of life. For long have we said, we are not of the world. Yes, we are not of the world. But as long as we are still living in this world, you should participate in every area and shine the light of God so that darkness can give way. God needs his children to serve as light everywhere. The good thing is that the time he wants us to do this is now, not tomorrow. He wants you to shine in your school. Now that you are still the principal of that school, begin to shine for him. He wants you to shine in the hospital. Now that you are the chairman in that hospital, please begin to shine. He wants you to shine in politics. As he's putting the desire in you to go into politics, don't say, oh, politics is a dirty game, I don't want to go there. And that's how they are soiling it every day. Go in there and shine for the Master. The one who has breathed on you to go there will not abandon you midstream. It is time to shine. For this reason, this daddy talking and I quote, I told my children during annual Thanksgiving service at the redemption camp that they should become active members of the political associations of their choice. Enough of hiding our faces. Let's be involved. Let's shine in every area of life. In today's Bible reading, we see how Elijah the prophet exhibited cowardice just after his exploit for God on Mount Carmel. Because he was afraid of Jezebel, the powerful queen, he ran for his life and hid in the wilderness. After encountering God on Mount Sinai, the Lord commanded him to continue his assignment as prophet. In 1 Kings 19:15a, it says, and the Lord said unto him, go, return on thy way to the wilderness of Damascus. In other words, he should hide no more. He had to show his face and go to complete his assignment as the prophet of God. Hiding our faces as children of God cannot help this generation. Some of us exhibit cowardice
and are reluctant to face up this challenge. We must show our faces by confronting ungodliness in all spheres of life if we will make meaningful impacts in our generation. Action point. Study the characteristics of the city set on a hill, light and salt, Matthew 5:13-16, and begin to exhibit these characteristics. And what are the characteristics of the two? Characteristics of a city set on a hill, light and salt. Salt gives taste to food. Salt preserves decay of food. Salt kills germs and bacteria, which can cause food poisoning. Light drives away darkness. Light provides direction. Light and joy works together as twins. Our good work must project Jesus to the whole world. Prayer point. We want to say, Father, every hindrance to my shining, remove them today in Jesus' name. Every hindrance to my shining, Lord, I command they be removed now in the name of Jesus. Every hindrance to my shine have been commanded by the Master to arise and shine. And I will shine. In this generation, I will shine. In Jesus' name we pray. My Father and my God, I ask that the grace to shine be released upon us all now in Jesus' name. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can we please sing hymn 16?
Open the floodgates of heaven. sing out. There.